It's not the wealth I'm concerned with. It's selling yourself out for the wealth. It's putting wealth at the top and doing it for that. It's just, I pity people like him, but we've got to stay on Glenn Beck. We've got to expose his lies.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
I'm going to run through your phone calls here in a moment, the next two segments. Then I'm going to spend the last 40 minutes of this hour detailing the banking takeover. I know I harped on this in January, February, March, April, May, and then they withdrew the financial reform plan and went for the healthcare takeover of 20% of the economy. But now they're back. And so we're going to go over this in great detail, but first I want to take your calls. In summation on Glenn Beck, though, the very fact that the establishment has tried to put him at the head of the anti-New World Order, libertarian, true conservative slash classical liberal movement, the awakening, people that the majority of the population that don't like left or right. I saw close-up photos. It was blacks, whites, Hispanics, liberals, conservatives, libertarians, anti-New World Order, our Joker posters, Infowars.com. I'd say about a third of the people were our listeners. A third or more were Glenn Beck's people, and the rest were just mainline Republicans and libertarians. But they wouldn't be putting Glenn Beck out there as the leader. They wouldn't be playing this dangerous game of even trying to get at the head of this movement if they didn't know massive revolution and resistance was mounting to their New World Order. That's why they put a Judas goat at the front of this. A Judas goat, for those that don't know, a lot of sheep operations that produce mutton don't just shear the sheep and sell their wool. They kill a large portion of them every year, particularly the younger, fatter, plumper, juicier ones. A certain amount get cut out for mutton. And the ram is the leader. And, you know, the male sheep, he is the leader. The Judas sheep, or the Judas goat in the case of goats, and he will lead the goats or the sheep into the pen for the slaughter. And he goes out the other end and the others don't. There's no doubt Glenn Beck's a Judas goat. And I just want to mark the chart, just like we're out on the ocean and I'm marking a place I found submerged rocks and I ran my boat over it and I'm just putting a buoy out and I'm marking the chart saying there is a big old rock 1 foot under the water. It's definitely a rock. And watch out. And you can ignore me and drive your boat right over it. But I'm not saying don't go to the tea parties. I'm not saying, no, go to them and take them over. Use their gamble to try to take over our movement, to take over their movement. The problem is when Fox News with tens of millions of viewers got involved, they got control of it. And it's always been Pentagon run. I mean, Glenn, you have talked about this briefly, about how the White House science czar called to put poisons in our water and sterilize us. But then you also get up on your TV show and said that the DHS report was good, that there are right-wing extremists. You were apologetically in support of it. You were 60-40, 60% in support of the DHS, and had milquetoast guests on that supported the DHS report saying veterans are the number one threat and gun owners are the number one threat to Homeland Security. So just give us a break. I mean, I want to believe in you. I know Pat Buchanan isn't perfect. I know Lou Dobbs aren't perfect, but I'm not up here bashing them. I don't want to be associated with all those timid souls who attack anybody that puts their head up, with the people that have created a cottage industry just out of attacking me. I'm not asking folks to do that, to just go out and attack you and make stuff up about you. But for people to go, look at your record, pal. You supported the banker bailout when almost no one else did. You go to the White House over and over again to get marching orders from Bush. You attack 9/11 Truth. And Glenn Beck's a smart guy, folks. He's been sent the evidence. He knows the FEMA camps are real. He knows 9/11's an inside job. Glenn, look at what you've done. Why did I spend the last 30 minutes talking about Glenn Beck? Because, mark my words, he is at a key juncture and is a key man in the New World Order's plan in this country. He is getting your confidence so that when he betrays you, when he slits our collective throats, we won't struggle, but a look up at him like a Labrador retriever when you slit its throat with sadness. Like our own father has just shot us between the eyes. And I just can't believe how gullible people are. Absolutely gullible. But that's just like people support Obama. It's the same cult of personality, same thing. He lies. He's disingenuous. It's obviously a corporate scam. The evidence is clear. It doesn't matter. They like being deceived because they've been raised from the time they were in diapers, sitting in front of television sets. Okay, let's take a bunch of phone calls, and I'm going to get into what's happening with the economy. My message, my open letter to Glenn Beck. This is your last chance, Glenn, to not be a Benedict Arnold in history. I really want Glenn Beck to be for real, but he is definitely the most dangerous pundit on the left or right in the media. He is definitely following government scripts. If you want to know about somebody who's definitely spook run, it's Glenn Beck. And I want to explain to people how he's meant to lead the opposition right into the gates of hell. But I don't think Glenn Beck is an evil person. I think he's an actor, and you can look in his eyes. He is a very disturbed individual. We'll be right back. Stay with us.